Hi there and welcome to another session of business studies for the 12th standard with me Vishwanath sir. We continue where we last left off from and we hope to achieve excellence in whatever we do. Our quest for knowledge should be never ending. The concepts of each of the chapters should be understood more properly in order to get a bird's eye view about the entire thing. Your majority of the questions which come in the board exams in business studies are case studies. So we need to be very competent in whatever we do. That means reading up a chapter thoroughly, understanding each and every point, each and every concept, and the overall matter of the subject. For this, you need to focus on whatever study material you have, plus you should also read up the newspaper and certain important articles which come in your way. Not only this, when you're having plenty of time, please make use of the business channels also by watching it for a few hours, for a few minutes in a day. Okay, so from here I go to the first case study of today. We are with the chapter directing. Mr. Aditya, the assistant sales manager of ABC Limited, receives directions from Mr. Yatin, the area sales manager. After receiving the directions, Mr. Aditya gives the instructions to the sales executives working under him. Mr. Anurag, the production manager of Development Limited, plans to replace the old machinery with the latest one. All the workers are comfortable in operating with the old machinery. Therefore, they resisted to the change. However, Mr. Anurag decided to demonstrate the working of the new machinery and inform the workers about the change and its advantages. After attending the demonstration, the workers were satisfied and happily accepted the change. Identify and state the feature of directing discussed in the first paragraph and of course the importance of directing. The feature of directing here is that it flows from the top to the bottom. Okay, and remember one of the most important things about directing is that it facilitates the introduction of change. Okay, so that is a very important aspect. By this you can also further increase your answer by writing the other points of importance. Going to the next question. The employees of Yes Limited are happy and satisfied and they are loyal to the organization and feel secure. Identify the employees' needs the organization has satisfied. The organization has been successfully in satisfying A, the basic and the physiological needs, B, the safety and security needs, and C, the social affiliation needs. Okay, so these things have been done. So these employees who are working in Yes Limited are truly happy with where they are positioned. Tanya, a manager, always listens to the suggestions made by the subordinates before taking decisions regarding the marketing strategy. What leadership type does the manager possess? Yes, truly it's democratic leadership because the person listens to his subordinates and also executes the same. Mr. Pragyun sits in his office and sends emails to all his subordinates regarding what to do. He also directs the way to do an assigned task. Identify his style of leadership Mr. Pragyun has adopted. He has adopted autocratic leadership because along with the directions what he is giving, he is also telling them how to do it in a particular way. So this is autocratic leadership for you. Mr. Gurpreet holds meeting for his subordinates every Monday morning to discuss the previous week's work and also to plan for the current week. He welcomes suggestions from his subordinates and provides them with the freedom to sort out the day-to-day matters. Identify and describe the leadership adopted by Mr. Gurpreet. This is truly a democratic leadership because he is allowing suggestions to come by the way and is also giving them the freedom to provide certain important points. we go from here to the next point where Amrit was sitting in the office cafeteria with a group of co-workers. Sunaina, the personal assistant of the marketing manager, joined them. During the conversation, she informed the manager that the manager was planning to resign. Identify and state the type of informal communication network highlighted above. You can tell this is gossip network because under the gossip network, one person communicates with everyone on a non-selective basis. Okay, so the word is going to be spread around to everyone. Coming to the next case study, Pranav does not allow her subordinates to share information with each other. Okay, she holds individual meetings and gives the required instructions. Identify this and state the type of formal communication network highlighted here. We can tell this is a wheel network because under the wheel network, all communications pass through one superior who acts as a control authority at the hub of the wheel. The subordinates can communicate with one superior and are not allowed to talk with themselves. Okay, so this is a wheel network. Going to the next, employees exchange views only those whom they trust. Identify the type of grapevine communication highlighted by this statement. This is basically a cluster network where anyone is communicating anywhere. Mayank is looking for a job where he can earn at least 10,000 to make his living going. Identify Maslow's needs that are highlighted by this statement. So you can tell the basic physiological needs. Shivam was promoted to the post of area sales manager to recognize his efforts of the past. Identify Maslow's needs that are satisfied by promoting Shivam to the post of area sales manager. So this becomes an esteem need because he acquires a certain position. Mr. Sundar, the principal of Hum Sabka Vidyalay, hosts the Teachers' Day dinner at his place every year. He invites all the employees, including the support staff, for dinner. Identify Maslow's hierarchy need being fulfilled above. Yes, social affiliation and belongingness need. Okay, that all these three needs are put forward here. Jivanshu Limited gives a minimum annual rise of 10% in the salary to all the workers. It also ensures that all the workers are insured against accidents. Identify the needs which are satisfied above. We can tell the safety and the security needs are satisfied above. During a meeting, Mr. Himesh, the marketing manager, was addressing the problem of competitors' pricing policy. In the meeting, two executives were busy talking to each other about the plans coming for their upcoming holidays. The manager got distracted and forgot to inform the major changes in the company's pricing policy. So here, first, identify the communication barrier discussed above. Secondly, state the category of this communication barrier. First is lack of attention, of course. The next is physiological and emotional barrier because it is related to the state of mind, both of the sender and the receiver. Then we go to the next case study where Siddharth prefers to stay away from his boss. He's always scared of his boss. What if his boss rejects his suggestions? A. Identify the communication barrier highlighted. Simple, unwillingness to communicate. State the category of this communication barrier. It is a personal barrier because he has certain personal factors in his mind. Okay, and this is coming both in the way of the sender as well as the receiver. From here, I go to Karthik Furniture, who follows a principle of scalar chain very strictly. No employee whatsoever may even be the emergency is allowed to divert from the official lines of communication. Identify and state the category of communication barrier discussed above. So here, the barriers which are the organizational barriers which are discussed here are organization structure, authority, relationships, rules, and regulations. Going to the next case study, Mr. Yash has a pre-notion that his boss will always find faults in his presentation. During one of his presentation, his boss wanted to appreciate him for the good performance of the work. But before he could complete, Mr. Ghosh closed his presentation and left the room. Identify the communication barrier discussed here. This is premature evaluation because he is evaluating even before his boss has told him anything. Next, state the category of this communication barrier. It comes as a psychological and emotional barrier because it is related to the state of mind. Explain any other communication barrier in this same category. You can put lack of attention here. So that is one such thing. Coming to the next case study, Mr. Tushar, the finance manager, was busy preparing his presentation for a meeting when his secretary Neha came and asked him to sanction salary advance as the child was very ill. Due to the preoccupation, Mr. Tushar did not listen to her problem and rejected her request. This disappointed Neha and she decided to resign. Identify the communication barrier discussed above. This was lack of attention. So B, state the category of this communication barrier. So this could be psychological barriers. Okay. C, explain any other communication barrier of the same category. You can tell distrust also. Okay. Distrust. Going to the next point here. Vijay told his secretary to inform all the departments about the meeting at 10 a.m. in the conference room. She informed the three departments about the meeting timely. On her way, she met a friend and started talking to him and forgot to inform the other department heads about the meeting. Okay, so here we have to identify the communication barrier which is discussed. This is loss by transmission and poor retention. B, state the category of this communication barrier. So in this case, you can tell it is both the state of mind and body. Next, explain any other communication barrier of the same category. You can focus on premature evaluation, because without knowing much, you are coming to a conclusion on your own without actual conclusive evidences. Coming to the next case study, Mr. Akshay, the sales manager, takes suggestions from the sales executives and uses them for his presentation. In his presentation, he does not recognize or appreciate his sales executives. This disappoints them and they decide not to give any suggestions in the future. A, identify the communication barrier discussed above. So here the communication barrier which is discussed above is lack of proper incentives. State the category of this communication barrier. It is a personal barrier because it is related to the personal factors of both the sender and the receiver. Explain any other communication barrier of the same category. You can tell lack of confidence on his subordinates, the lack of confidence of superior on his subordinates. From here, I go to the next case study of Naman, who is working as a top level management of Pure Treatment Limited in Delhi. He is a team leader of the water treatment project. The project is acclaimed to be a huge success. He is proficient in English, Hindi and Punjabi. He also has a knowledge of Tamil. The company decides to give him a new project received at Chennai. The company then decides to send him there to repeat the success story. However, due to the lack of proficiency in Tamil, he is hesitant and in freely expressing his opinion. He decides to write the first message in English and then translate into Tamil. Despite this, he was not able to build a good rapport with his team. Identify the communication barrier that is identified here or discussed here, that is basically faulty translation. Then which category of this communication barrier you can tell it is a semantic barrier, as it is concerned with problems and obstructions in the process of encoding and decoding of a message into words. Then next, explain any other barrier in the same category. You can give this category as faulty translation. Okay, let's go through one more quickly. Poonam, working as a sales of the head of Ketan Limited, without discussing with the subordinate, she undertakes a project that requires the employees to travel out of Delhi. Despite her female colleagues telling her not to inform that they cannot travel outside Delhi, as they have taken care of, they have to take care of families too. Okay, despite this, he writes, she does not listen to them and imposes her decision on everyone and forces them to travel outside Delhi. Identify the style of leadership of Poonam. You can tell this style of leadership is autocratic leadership. This and much more in the coming. Please go through the case studies. Thank you so much. This is Vishwanath sir signing off.